When the European powers opted to carve up Africa, only two nations managed to remain independent. Liberia, a land carved out by the USA as a place for freedmen to return to Africa. The other was Ethiopia, then known as Abyssinia. What's so notable about Ethiopia maintaining its independence is that it did so standing against the European powers which wished to carve it up. And of course the big question is, how did Ethiopia manage to do this for so long? At least until Mussolini turned up, that is. So, during the scramble for Africa, Ethiopia wasn't united, but was centred on the Kingdom of Shewa and its surrounding vassals. Most of the time, these surrounding states were in a state of rebellion and would do anything they could to undermine or overthrow the Shewa's ruling dynasty. The head of this dynasty was Theodore II, who had himself just overthrown the last dynasty. Theodore sought to ally himself with the British so he could obtain modern firearms with which to put down rebels and expand his realm. They said no, and so Theodore gained the knowledge of how to make them from missionaries instead. Shewa was subject to raiding from places like Sudan and Somaliland, and Theodore thought that these were being backed by the British or the French. As such, he decided to imprison the British consul there in 1866. This wasn't a good idea. As such, the British sent an expeditionary force which subsequently defeated the Shewans, and Theodore promptly killed himself. The British didn't try to hold on to Shewa though after this, because that sounded expensive. Instead, they left, and the fractured land descended into infighting, which saw John, the leader of the Tigray here, win, and he became Negus. Negus was the title used to denote the rule over all of the other kingdoms within the area known as Ethiopia, and could be translated roughly as meaning King of Kings or as Emperor. John's reign saw him focus on Ethiopia's internal problems and also expand the kingdom a little bit until his death in 1889, which saw him succeeded by Menelik II. Menelik was a major reformer who aggressively pursued the expansion of his borders to make his kingdom more powerful. He created a centralized government, hired military advisors from the Russian Empire, and most importantly, he created a permanent capital, Addis Ababa, from which the empire would be run. By 1904, Menelik had expanded Ethiopia to this and had made agreements with the British and French on what the formal borders were. Of course, Ethiopia had one more neighbour to worry about, Italy, with which Ethiopia had signed the infamous Treaty of Ucale in 1889. The treaty gave Ethiopian recognition to these Italian lands in return for Italy giving military supplies and economic aid. Sounds good, except for one problematic section, which agreed that Ethiopia would only conduct foreign affairs through Italy. Menelik didn't think much of this part of the treaty, whereas as far as the Italians were concerned, Menelik had basically agreed to become their puppet. It wasn't long before Menelik renounced this part of the treaty in 1893, and so unsurprisingly, war. Menelik launched an invasion of Italian Eritrea, which was pushed back by the Italian forces. Italy would then invade Ethiopia, after which they would only suffer defeats, which included their notable one at the Battle of Adwa. Thus, by 1896, Ethiopia's independence was secured, and this was largely down to it having a series of intelligent emperors. They allied with European nations when necessary and obtained their innovations, whilst preventing them from gaining much influence in Ethiopia. Menelik's expansion, combined with his reform, stabilised and strengthened the empire, which, along with cunning diplomacy, allowed Ethiopia to survive the scramble for Africa. I hope you enjoyed this episode and thank you for watching, with extra thanks to my patrons that you see on screen now. And a special thanks to James Bizanette, Party Boyko, Azarka Flash, Chris Wicker, Rob Waterhouse, Michael Reynolds, Gustav Swan, Maggie Paxkowski, Winston Kaywood, Raphael, Adam Harvey, Anthony Beckett, Sky Chappelle, and the Amusement Park Archives.